Yo guys, it's Slyroh. You already know that today I am bringing you the battle, week 10 of the Pokemon Premier League. This week we are playing Rhyquinn and the Nidoqueens Park Rangers. If you can't tell by my voice, I am kind of sick, but I still want to bring you this live comp because this is going to be a really hype battle. So yeah, I am feeling a little sick, so I do apologize. But you know, we'll work with it. Hoping it doesn't affect my judgment or anything. I feel pretty calm about this match, surprisingly. I don't know if it's because I'm about to win really big or if I'm about to get completely destroyed. I guess we'll find out. Before we hop into the battle, I did change my team a little bit. I usually don't do this kind of thing, but I did change my team. So if you watched the team builder yesterday, then there's a couple things I need to go over. A, I changed Gardevoir to a Scarf Gardevoir because it's not very likely that he's going to bring Steelix or Tentacruel, and very unlikely that he'll bring both. I would just much rather be able to outspeed. I made it modest and gave it enough speed to outspeed a max speed Azelf, I think. I don't know if I bet crap wins caught or not. I don't think I did. It's 1 point, so at the very least, it's a speed tie to a max speed Timid Whimsicott, which, why would he even bring that? I also took Kecleon off the team entirely, and I brought Scizor instead with Defog, just in case he wants to bring Toxic Spikes and things like that. I don't want my defensive mons to get worn down, so I have Defog on Scizor, and I put Spikes on Greninja instead of Protect, because I don't think I'm going to be using Protect. I have better ways to scout for, Choice Scarfs and things like that than just wasting a turn using Protect, so I just threw Spikes on there. Everything else should be the same, and for those of you that did not watch my team builder, let me just say that I am bringing a Scarf Gardevoir, a Scarf Rotom Heat, specially defensive, bulk up, Scrafty, Life Orb, Greninja, physically defensive Meluetta, and specially defensive Scizor, and the Scizor set is Bullet Punch, U-Turn, Roost, and Defog. Let's go ahead down the list. We have Hydreigon. There's no Mandibuzz. Awesome, I don't need to worry about that. That's great. There's a Mamoswine. There's no Whimsicott, I don't need to worry about that. There is a Tentacruel. There is an Infernape. There is a Rotomoe. There is an Azelf. Okay, I almost thought there was no Azelf. I was like, what? And no Steelix. Okay, see. So he didn't bring Steelix. That was stupid of me to... I almost didn't bring Scarf Gardevoir just because... I was fearing the things and stuff. If you heard that, I have no idea what that was. There was a big thump in the background. I kind of want to lead off with Rotom Heat. I don't mind revealing Choice Scarf right off the bat. Maybe if he sees that Scarfer, he might not anticipate a second one. We'll see. Between my six mons, I have three different items. I have three mons with leftovers, two with Choice Scarf, and then a Life Orb. So, not that much variety, but... Whew, let's go ahead and get into this. I hope I... hit everything. Me and Rhyquinn always have pretty good battles whenever we do battle. He's in a spot where he needs to win this week, so, but, if things go against us, you know, we don't want to lose this week either, because, if everything goes against us, we lose bad the next 2 weeks, we could end up in 10th place, and that's not okay. So, we're gonna try and win, plus I don't want to give anybody a victory, but this is the lead matchup that I anticipated. I figured he was gonna lead off with Mamoswine, so I can just Will-O-Wisp him right off the bat. And we'll see. He's probably just going to get up rocks, which would be fine. I am going to hit the Will-O-Wisp, so that's great. And then I don't know if he's scarfed or not. He's going to go for Stealth Rock, so he's probably not scarfed. He might just be a Sash Lead, but yeah. Looking at his team, I don't think he has a way to Heal Bell anything, so this is probably burn for the match. And I'm going to switch right into Scizor, just to see if I can get off a Defog. See if he might just go for an attack, which I doubt. But if I can get off a Defog, that would be pretty great. Because I don't really want rocks on my side of the field. Rotom Heat has very limited switch-ins. And I don't really want that to happen. Plus, I don't want my defensive mons, especially Meluetta, who doesn't really have reliable recovery. I don't want it taking a lot of hazard damage. So, burn the Mamoswine, that's basically what I wanted to have happen. Now, if this is Sash, then, you know, I won't really feel bad about not bringing Kecleon. If this turns out to not be Sash, and I could have just O-coded it with a Scarf Kecleon with a low kick, you know, I'll be kind of like, whatever, but let's see if he switches out or not. He's going to withdraw, and he goes into Hydreigon. Alright. So that means I can't go for Defog yet. because even being specially defensive, I can't take a fire blast thrower, you know, whatever it is. yeah, like even level 50 timid scarf fire blast is a guaranteed Okoda, especially defensive scissor. So I'm gonna go into my check counter thing, which is going to be Hood Dragon Scrafty. And I kind of want to see if he did bring physical Hedragon. I don't think he will because it matches up against my team not as well. But I know when RTK had Rotom Heat, he brought Head Smash on Hedragon. So let's find out. This is especially defensive Scrafty. And maybe we can find out if this thing's like Life Orb or something. But he is just going to go straight for the Flamethrower. Alright. So let's see if we can try and figure out what this is. Unless it just reveals the Life Orb now. No, it didn't. Okay. Scrafty. Alright. So it went for Flamethrower, not Fire Blast. And I am at 132 health right now. So, I'm at 77%. I think I was at 161 though. Which means that the attack did like 17%. Is this even max special attack? Is this even max special attack? I don't even think it is. I don't know if he has any great switches. So I'm gonna go for a knockoff, actually, because he doesn't want any of his items to get knocked off. I have leftovers. I think he's gonna switch out. He might be scarfed, but he might not be. A max special attack timid flamethrower does more than what he just did. He can't be zero attack, can he? He could be zero attack. Maybe this is a physical one with flamethrower. So I'm gonna have to be really, really careful about that. But he doesn't have a great switch into a knockoff at all. He doesn't want any of his items to get knocked off. So let's find out. He's going to withdraw. What's losing their item? Mimoswine. I guess we'll find out if this thing is sashed or not. I almost went for Drain Punch as well. Focus Sash. Alright, we'll see if he makes the double switch again. I'm going to go into Scizor just because he's burned. You know, no reason not to. And then, he might just try and get some damage. He might double switch on me. I really want to get rocks off the field, not gonna lie. But the only thing that he can do, well, no, that's a lie. Okay, he didn't switch out. So I'm gonna get a defog off. There's no way he can hit KO me when he's burned. And I believe that was a focus sash that I knocked off. I barely even looked. He's gonna knock off my leftovers. That kind of sucks. But he outspeeds me, which means that we can't go for, like, you know, defog, stealth rocks, shenanigans. Like, if I outsped, then I could go for defog, and then he just goes for rocks, and he does that until he dies. But because he outspeeds, I can go for defog now, and then I can go for bullet punch, just to make sure that he doesn't get up rocks again. He could still have rocks on Infernape or Azelf. But I don't know. I feel like he definitely doesn't have it on all three. I don't know if he has a second rocket or not. But he has to decide whether he wants to sack Mamoswine here and get some chip damage, or if he wants to switch it out for Death Fodder later on. I'm really glad that I was able to not let Mamoswine run through my team. It was a pretty decent issue for me, but I knew just having things to outspeed it would make it a whole ton easier for me to deal with. So last season we had our match went down to like 2 minutes left, and already something's almost dead. So I don't know. I feel like it's not going to be quite as long. I don't know if this match is going to be over quite as quickly, because we both are very thorough with our decisions. I usually take a decent amount of time to make my moves. He takes a decent amount of time to make his moves, which I completely respect. In league format, when you need a win, you should be making every decision as carefully as you possibly can. So he's going to go into Hydreigon, while I defog, and then, Now, if he could be physical, he could be backing something like Superpower, which I don't really like. I don't really like at all. Bullet Punch is not enough chip damage for it to be worth me doing it. So, what do I want to switch into? Scrafty is my main switch in, though. If he is... Alright, hold on. If he's physical with superpower, I mean, is that gonna kill Scrafty? It's not gonna kill Scrafty. And then if he's choiced into it, we can work around that. Maybe, see if I go into Meloetta, then he, no, that's a stupid move. I'm gonna go into Scrafty and just see, this is really risky. Alright, so he's just gonna double switch, probably into Azelf, Fire Monkey. That works as well. I thought about going for U-turn, because Rhyquinn definitely likes to double switch a lot. But we do have rocks off the field, which is very, very nice. So now we're going to go into my physically defensive wall, which is going to be Meloetta. I'm pretty sure that's not going to be something that he prepared for. I don't think he's going to prepare for Meloetta to be my physically defensive mon. When I have things like Scizor, I used Scrafty as a physically defensive mon last week, as well as Rotom. So I have options, and Tangela, but Tangela just didn't do well enough, in my opinion, to be worth bringing to this battle. Mostly because it could get its Eviolite knocked off. But because it was Focus Sash Mamo, Tangela could have switched in, but Mamoswine gets knocked off and things like that. He might just U-turn here, because switch initiative and things that he likes. But he's going to go for the close combat. Ooh, is that banded? Oh, that's a crit. Alright. Alright. Meloetta. Wow. So that close combat. We're at full health. We're definitely at full health. We're at 83 health. It did 60% with a critical hit. So that close combat was a crit. Meaning that he's probably just some sort of focus sash. So now without a crit, it's a roll to take me out. So I'm actually gonna protect. Because it's a roll to take me out. He's not Life Orb. And so a max attack. Oh, that's a Jolly. If he's Adamant, it's a guaranteed can take me out, yeah. So yeah, if he's max attack Adamant, he guarantees takes me out, but I'm going for Protect, so he's not going to. He might overthink it. He might try and go for U-turn. We'll see. Do I get up enough health here? Okay, he's just going to U-turn. I could Toxic anything that might want to switch in. He's definitely going to U-turn again, I think. I think he's just going to U-turn again. But then he'll be able to switch in basically anything he wants. Let's see. I mean, alright, so he's definitely not choice. He's probably either Focus Sash or, like, Expert Belt or something. I think I just want a Toxic, but at the same time, I feel like there's a better play to make here. Alright. Let's see. How much time do I have? Alright, I have enough time. Let me see how well... Burnham Heat doesn't want to take a close combat. But I guess I could. I'm going to be kind of risky, and I'm going to go into Burnham Heat. He can't take me out with close combat if that's what he does. But I think he might just U-turn. Because I can't stop him from doing that. Okay, cool. Cool. Yeah. 26. Wait, now that U-turn did way more. I don't know. Yeah, I'm not entirely sure. Maybe I'm not reading that right. I literally... I'm not sure how a U-turn did that much damage, actually. This is the right Rotom Heat. Yeah, I don't know how that did. That wasn't even supposed to do that much damage. Alright. This thing is scarfed. I think he's scarfed, and I think he has Head Smash. I'm gonna try going into Scrafty again. He might U-turn. I think his Hydreigon has to be scarfed, and I think he might have Head Smash. See, Head Smash is cool when you bring it once, but if he did bring it this week, that's like the third time he's brought it, and it stops being a surprise after you bring it multiple times. So, let's find out. He could just be going for U-turn, because Rhyquinn likes his initiative. Flash Cannon. Alright, he might be fully special then. Alright. This time I think I'm gonna go for Drain Punch. I think he might sack off his Mamoswine here. Cause I can't really bulk up while Azelf is alive, because he can bring Azelf in at any time just to Dazzling Gleam me, which is a guaranteed Oko. As well as Infernape's close combat. Probably takes me out as well, because I don't have physical. I mean, after a bulk up, it probably wouldn't, but still, it's not the point. So I think he might be fully special then. I could have just stayed in. So next time that matchup happens, if it does happen again, I'll know that he's fully special. So because we've seen Flash Cannon, and I don't remember what else we saw. I actually don't remember what else we saw. That's stupid. I should remember. Alright, so Scrafty's gonna kill Mamoswine here. Scrafty. Alright, so Scrafty kills Mamoswine. I think that's Scrafty's first kill for the team. So, good job, Scrafty. And Mamoswine is down. Which is cool, but at the same time, it's like, eh. I think he's going to bring an Azelf, and I think he's just going to U-turn. But I'm not sure. Really not sure what he's thinking here. Just going to wait and see. But we did get the first knockout, which is cool. Now the problem is Infernape is becoming more of an issue because Meloetta can't really switch in again. So we're gonna have to play really, really carefully around that thing. Which sucks. I'm hoping he doesn't bring that in right now. I think he's just gonna bring an Azelf. Especially if it has U-turn. especially if it has U-turn. Dang it, he just brought in Fire Monkey. Alright, let me see. Alright. Let's see. I think he's just gonna U-turn here, but I know I don't really have a switch into a close combat actually. I'm pretty sure even Rotom Heat at this point is, no, I can't even switch into Rotom Heat. I'm going into Scizor, mostly because I think he's going to U-turn, but because it's the most expendable member, if he does go for anything else. He goes for close combat. We might be able to live that one, actually. Oh, yeah, okay, we live on 8. I'm going to go for a Bullet Punch to break any potential sashes. But I really wish I could figure out what exactly this thing is. Oh, Mach Punch, why did stupid me? Alright, either way. Scissor's dead. And then... Now see, the issue is... Volt. Is that I Volt? Okay. This is looking really bad for us, actually. But I'm gonna go into Rotom Heat, and I'm gonna Volt Switch. He can know I'm Scarf, that's fine. He's gonna withdraw. I think that thing has to have a sash. I think it has to have a sash. Okay. Now that I have initiative, I go back into Scrafty, and then I go for knockoff, because everything on his team right now has an item. And then we knock off an item. If I could knock off this thing's Scarf, that'd be great, because then I can just go for Gardevoir. But I think Gardevoir's gonna have to punch more holes more so than clean up, maybe, it depends. He hasn't even brought in Azelf or Rotomo or Tentacruel. Like, there's literally half his team that hasn't even seen the field yet, where he's seen my entire team, except for Gardevoir, I think. Yeah, I think the rest of my mons have hit the field. If he's hiding any sneaky shenanigans for this Scrafty on this Hydreigon, now would be the time to do so, but I don't think he does. I think he brought a fully special Scarf Hydreigon. Maybe just in case of a Scarf Kyurem. And so we can also do damage to Greninja. I don't know. That's thinking too far down the battle. Is I could probably work around his scarfing, choice him into certain moves. You know, like if he's choiced into Dark Pulse, I could go into Greninja and probably do a lot of damage. I'd have to double check that with Calc, but I don't know. Greninja's kind of frail. So we'll see. Especially if this is Modest, which it probably is. Oh, maybe not. He might have went timid to outspeed a Scarf Kyurem. Gonna go for Draco. He's gonna miss. I don't think Draco would have done that much, to be fair. And there's the Wise Glasses. He wasn't choiced at all. Sneaky. Sneaky. I'm going for Drain Punch now. Sneaky. You got me for sure, Rhyquinn. Good job. Alright, so he's got, what, Flash Cannon, Draco, probably a Dark Pulse. I think he might have revealed Dark Pulse, I'm not sure. And then, he might have Roost. Or U-Turn. He hasn't gone for U-Turn yet, though. Alright, so what are we going to do? He's going into Azelf. Oh, if I could have went for Knockoff there. He could have Cobra Berry, though. Ah, that did nothing. That did literally nothing. Alright, so let's, I feel like he has to go for a Dazzling Gleam, but he might not. He could go for a U-turn of some sort. Let me see. I still like having this round for Hydreigon. But this could be something crazy. Alright, I have to be really careful about how I want to play around Azelf. Really careful. Moonblast does a decent chunk for sure. Meloetta almost becomes my switch into things and stuff. I might make the aggressive switch into Gardevoir, because I haven't been making very many aggressive switches. Max Special Attack, Modest Life Orb Shadow Ball still won't take out Gardevoir, so I'm going to make the offensive switch into Gardevoir. Which might be a really bad move, especially because this thing's probably physical. Let's find out. I'm going to go for the Dazzling Gleam, okay. 153. Alright, can we find out what this thing is? That did 34%. So. Okay. It's probably Max Special Attack Modest. Which is fine. I could go. I'm just going to go for the Moonblast. The switch into Tentacruel is pretty obvious, but I'm not scared at all about Tentacruel coming in, because Tentacruel doesn't really do much to me. If Tentacruel comes in, I might try and go into Meloetta, and I don't know, maybe not, we'll see. But now he has to start dealing with this thing. If he hasn't realized it until now, he should know that Moonblast does way too much to his entire team. Like, it's not even funny. It does so much. He might have some HP investment and live this, but he does not. There's no crit, so Gardevoir kills Azelf. Gardevoir. I think that was a roll. Because max was 90%, it was 76.6 to 90.6% was the roll if he doesn't have any HP investment. Which he probably has very minimal HP investment, so, but that might have still been a roll. So let me go ahead and cross out Azelf, that's good. The only issue is that every single time he gets a switch into freaking, Infernape. Well, no, he doesn't want to switch that in now. Alright, so this has to be Scarfrutimo. I'm actually going to go into Scrafty. Scrafty is especially defensive, plus I think he's just going to Volt Switch. Yeah. I think I'm starting to see how this is going to start going. I think the pace of this battle is going to pick up really quickly right now. I switch into Scrafty, he Volt Switches, and then Azelf is gone, actually. Ooh. But he still has Infernape. If he Volt switches into Infernape, then I switch out, sack off Meloetta, go into Rotom Heat, Volt switch on him, and we go from there. That's what I'm predicting. But if he goes for some sort of attack right now, let me just see. It's still, I mean, close combat. I want to check. Alright, so I'm going to switch out. And he's going to go for Volt Switch. Where he's probably going to go into Infernape. If I could just get up a bulk up now, that'd be great. There's the Infernape. So now, I'm gonna sack off Meloetta. Greninja is not actually helping me that much this match, so that's something to keep in mind. But I think I'm gonna sack off Meloetta. Meloetta, I've brought it, what, twice? And both times it's basically just been brought in to be sacked off. The crit definitely played a big part of that. For example, he might go for a close combat. I might actually live, but then he can just Mach Punch take me out, which he would have every reason to do, and I would probably let him so I can get a free switch. But he has no reason not to close combat right now. Even if he U-turns and goes into something else, I might just let Meloetta die regardless. Because that just makes sense to me. So there's the close combat. Just fine, and I live on 4. That's funny. That's funny. That actually works out really well for me. Okay, never mind. But his defense is down 1. So, like, I still kind of want to go into... Alright, here's the thing. I could go into Rotom Heat, which he can't outspeed, and then with minus 1 special defense, Volt Switch does a lot. Or I can go into Greninja, which I should be able to live a Mach Punch. Yeah, if he's max attack adamant, what if he's expert belt? Let's find out. If he's max attack adamant expert belt, he does not take out Greninja. So I'm just going to go into Greninja. Scald. And Scald kills 2 Infernapes with the minus 1 special defense. So I'm just going to go ahead and go for Scald. But he is going to withdraw. And he's going to go into his Tentacruel. That's fine. Alright, did not get the burn. And we... So this is probably some sort of a specially defensive Tentacruel, maybe. And so even Dark Pulse or whatever else isn't going to do enough. Although, no, he switches out of Infernape, and that really sucks, actually. I almost want to get chip damage off on this thing. Because I don't know if he's going to stay in. I could also go for Spike, so that way the next time Infernape comes in, he loses his sash. I actually think that's the smarter play. I'm going to go for Spikes. There we go. That's going to break any Infernape sash, which I'm almost convinced that he has right now. He got a crit on that. That's funny. And then I'm going to Dark Pulse for chip damage. He can't do a whole lot, and if I see that he's going to play Rapid Spin Shenanigan Games, then I can go into... I could go into, like, Rotom Heat as he goes for a Rapid Spin. That would be really risky. I could also go into Meloetta, which is a little bit less risky. If he goes for Rapid Spin here, he has to be... He has to be concerned about, keeping a Focus Sash intact on Infernape, because he hasn't let me do a single bit of damage on that thing. It hasn't taken Life Orb recoil, so... but I'm actually out of range where I die to a Mach Punch, so... I'm playing pretty aggressively. That's just what it is. I want to try and get chip damage on this thing and see what he's going to do. He's going to go for a Giga Drain. Alright. That's fine. I can save this thing off for fodder. Or for potentially just doing a lot of damage to Hydreigon. I'm actually not entirely sure if he is fully... fully specially defensive or not. Gardevoir takes too much damage, even from a fully defensive if it's a sludge wave. I think I scald. No, I can Dark Pulse. I can Dark Pulse pretty safely. I'm gonna get some chip damage off. I'm gonna let Greninja go down. Okay. Ha, he doesn't even get a kill. He doesn't even get to kill. He goes for Scald. I wanna try winning with Scrafty. And I think he knows this is coming. He can fish for Scald Burns, but I have Shed Skin. And after definitely like two bulk ups, I think I can just Drain Punch the rest of his team. This is really close, actually. Because I feel like I'm still at a range where I can live a close combat from Infernape if I get a bulk up. I think he's seen my leftovers. He knows I don't have Lumberry, but I'm actually risking. He's gonna have to fish for burns, or do something else, and then I have to kind of rely on Shed Skin. But he just went for rest, so that's a thing he did, which is fine. But now that Azelf is dead, show me your answer. Pliss. Drain. Punch and knockoff. Oh, knockoff does a lot to this thing, actually. But I'm going to get up one more bulk up. Is he going to go for Sleep Talk? Scald, Giga Drain, Rest, Sleep Talk? Yep. So now he's hoping for a Scald and a Burn, but he gets a Rest. Can a knockoff take this thing out? Since I'm at plus two. I might want to get one more up. I might want to get one more up. That could be greedy. I'm going to go for one more. I don't know if one more is too much. Or not. Sleep talk. Rest. Okay. So he didn't get any damage off at all. So we don't even get to find out if I, if shed skin stuff would even have played into, played any part of this. I might just win here, but I'm too hesitant to say that right off the bat. I feel kind of bad for Rhyquinn if he gets swept by two bulk up users in one season. He's gonna go for Scald. Let's find out if he gets the burn. He does get the burn. Alright, so this knockoff is not gonna take him out. And Shedskin is going to help me out here. Shedskin is going to be a friend. So I'm going to go ahead and knock off again. And see what do. See what do indeed. I think knockoff still does more than drain punch at this point. He has to be trying to figure out a way to win. If Scrafty gets 5 kills this match, I don't want to hear anybody talk crap as to why I got this thing. There's no burn that time. I'm going to knock off, and Tentacruel is going to go down. So Scrafty kills Tentacruel. Also, I feel like every single game that I brought Gardevoir offensively, it's definitely gotten at least one kill, as it got one kill this match so far. So let me go ahead and cross out Tentacruel. And then, I think he has to try, wait, I'm at plus 3. I don't think there's any way his Infernape even comes close to taking me out. I mean, maybe 2. I don't, say maybe 2, let's see, let's focus, actually, it doesn't matter. 2 close combats could probably take me out. Oh, no, they don't. 2 close combats don't even take me out. Drain Punch is a roll to kill Infernape. So I think he might lose. And then Rotom-o, which I'm assuming is Scarfed, because that's the one I've been expecting. Knockoff takes that thing out. Or I could Ice Punch, which easily takes him out. Why does Ice Punch and Knockoff do almost the same amount to a Rotom-o? That's funny. This may put the nail in the coffin for Rhyquinn's season, and I feel kind of bad. However, it's his responsibility to... No, that sounds mean. I was going to say, like, it's his responsibility to win games. I'm going to... I feel like he's going to have to Will-O-Wisp. I could knock off his Choice Scarf. I'm going to do that. I'm going to knock off his Choice Scarf, because I feel like he's going to go... Okay, he's just going to go for a Thunderbolt. 34 to 86. And that is going to take him out. Did I even find out what item he was? Yeah, there it is, Scarf. Alright, Scrafty kills Rotom-o. Infernape can't take me out from where I'm at. And Hydreigon definitely can't take me out from where I'm at. I think Scrafty just picked up 5 kills. So, tell me... I forget who it was that said that Scrafty was bad, but tell me how Scrafty is bad. Tell me how it was a bad move for me to get Scrafty and then proceed to get 5 kills against Rhyquinn for a 3-0 victory. I don't know. A crit could turn this around. However, I outspeed both his remaining mons with Gardevoir and can Moonblast him. So I still have backup options. I still have backup options. As well as, what's the third thing that I have alive? I'm gonna have to look up for that. I just wanna look at that. There's the Infernape. There's the spikes. So I'm gonna ask him if that Infernape was sashed. Okay, so it's Gardevoir and Rotom Heat that are still alive. Look at the new transfers putting in work. Rotom Heat and freaking Scrafty. So as far as I know, this close combat should not be able to take me out, because I'm at plus 3 defense. There we go. He's at minus 1 defense, so this Drain Punch is easily going to kill him. Goodbye, Infernape. I'm sorry, Rhyquinn. After he kills Infernape. I feel like I might have been on the lucky side of a lot of rolls. I'm not sure. But, regardless, I don't think he should have risked his Azelf like that. His Azelf was the thing stopping the Scrafty. He could have seen the set coming literally a mile away. And, yeah. So, this, as long as, okay, so there's a Draco. We should live, right? Regardless, then we kill with Gardevoir. So, regardless of anything, we live again. So Scrafty's gonna get 5 kills, holy crap. So Scrafty kills Hydreigon. This is going to give us 6 wins for the season, putting us in a better chance to finish in like the top 5 area. We're at 6 in the table now. We might be in top 5 after this. Whew. Good game, Rhyquinn. There's definitely some things to be said about that game. Scrafty just got himself 5 kills. Gardevoir got itself a kill. Greninja didn't really do much. Rotom Heat kept some initiative. Meloetta just has been a disappointment since I got it, but we'll see if it continues that way. But it's just been unlucky, because that was a crit this game that basically made it useless. I'm glad I brought Sizzler instead of Kecleon, because I was able to defog away the rocks, which definitely helped. I think Rhyquinn definitely could have played better. I think he knows that. Definitely can't wait to talk to him to find out what some of his sets were. I'm still not sure about the Infernape. I think it was Sash, but I don't know. That U-turn did a lot of damage to my Rotom Heat. I think that could just be Showdown Calc being stupid. As well as what his plans were for Azelf. So, yeah, that's going to be the match. Make sure you go check out Rhyquinn, see his side of the match and all that good stuff. And I feel kind of bad because if things don't go his way, then he's definitely going to end up in at least 10th place. If he ends up in 10th place on the table, he'll still have a chance to fight for his life in Division 1, which is perfectly fine. However, Colton is kind of getting a bit of resurgence, and if Colton goes on a bit of a winning streak, Rhyquinn could end up in 11th place, which would guarantee him a spot in D2, and I would feel bad about that. But at the same time, we need to do what's best for us. We had to do everything that we could to win. This is guaranteeing us a safe spot. We are not going to Division 2 at all. There's literally no way. We have ourselves a winning record for the season, and we have a chance to get our 7th victory next week when we take on Alex Onesie-Banette of the Kelta Dino, whatever. We take him on next week. That's going to be a great match. So, yeah. There's that. I can't wait for that. We'll talk about next week when it gets to next week. Thanks for watching this match, guys. Hope you enjoyed. Go ahead and leave a comment, like, all that good stuff, and I'll see you next time. So until then, guys, stay sly.